Hello, everybody. I got some emails that was given to me a little while ago. I'm going to address some of these comments that was given to me. This wasn't posted on YouTube. This was actually posted via email to me. And the combination of these emails that I have received was one of the thing is, quote unquote, the book was being racist when that's not true. The person even stated that the Bible never talked about, quote unquote, slavery. And that is also not true. If you look in the book of Exodus and you find out how Moses got the Egyptians out of bondage, that was based on racism. This was why in the whole deal of how the Ten Commandments was written, in which God gave Moses the Ten Commandments. The thing is, as the story gets in talking about the second seven plagues that was given to Ramses. One was a plague of locusts. Another one was a plague of frogs, turning the river into blood. So, in accordance to the Bible, that information was in fact incorrect because of the Old Testament. And in fact, even the stories behind, quote-unquote, the Sodom and Gomorrah was more about racism and other things that was mentioned, sins that the Bible was talking about in creating diversity and creating other elements. The fact is that this book brings in the term Hitler, but in reality, the Hitler that is mentioned in the book wasn't the Hitler in our history. It was rather an alternative Hitler, in which Hitler was a good guy. He was pro-Jew, rather than being anti-Jew in what our world is. And even technically, there was probably only one chapter where one scene where Hitler even was speaking in the book. So, the whole point, and that was in Majestic's Dream, to start the book off. So, this person is under the impression that one thing, when in reality, if you read the book, you would find out very plain and simple that Hitler was used, but it wasn't used in the way that a typical writer would use Hitler. And books, and he says that you have sets of rules and sets of guidelines in it. A writer doesn't have to go by the typical rule set, unlike the rules that are done in real life. A writer has the ability to set a set of rules. That means that a writer can sit there and set any amount of rules for the character to create the drama in order to get the book to be interesting for someone who is picking up the book, if that makes sense. In other words, in Star Flash episode 3, we introduce the grandfather paradox. What is the grandfather paradox? A lot of people talks about this real policy. Well, if you went into your past and you decided to kill your grandfather, then you cease to exist because you murdered your grandfather. If that makes sense. So, First of all, I'm not racist. I don't believe in racism, but I like to create topics that are interesting. The whole point of Starflash Episode 3 talks about a topic that is a little bit controversial, but at the same time, it introduces a thing. And plus, the whole point of Episode 3 was to tell a joke. A joke that the reader can understand by reading both Episode 1, Episode 2, and Episode 3 to understand the parody that I put into the book, and I slipped it under the wall. And the ending to the book is quite surprising. Leading into Episode 4, that is going to be a little bit interesting when January resumes. So for the record, I wanted to respond to this comment. Have a nice day.